problems that nothing in this present world can satisfy. There is only one probable explanation. I was made for another world. You were made for another world. Tonight, God sent this crazy shout, screaming, Chocolate Brother from Dallas, Texas, to tell you. Don't make the mistake of trying to quench your spiritual thirst with things that are natural. It's time for you to come back tonight to the living water who can satisfy your soul. So worship him again tonight. Remember what Jeremiah says, Jeremiah 2:13. This is God's indictment against his people. He says, for my people have done two evil things. They have abandoned me, the fountain of living water. They have dug for themselves cracked cisterns that can hold no water at all. Wondering tonight, what is the cracked cistern that you keep going back to? And God saying, tonight, would you come to me, and not just come to me, but you got to come to me and take a drink. He says, I know the thirst is real. Telling you, come to me, the living water, and take a drink. So worship team, come and play softly behind me because I sound a whole lot more spiritual when song music. Yeah. Worship team, y'all can come. I want you to see something real quick. I have on this stage right here, on this awesome chair, it is a cup with water in it. So it's not ordinary water, this is actually living water. It's living water. I think we shipped this in from Israel. No, we didn't. But this is it's living water. It's been sitting on this chair, sitting on the stage, the moment I started preaching. And if you're in this room tonight and you're like me and you're analytical and you're always looking at stuff, you're wondering, maybe you looked at this water and you had questions about this water. You're like, why in the world is that water sitting on that bar stool like that? You had questions about the living water. That's where some people stay as it relates to the things of the Spirit, as it relates to who Jesus is. They have so many questions. You ever met those people that are like, oh man, I would believe it, but man, I just got some questions. I don't know. I got some questions, man. I don't know if I can really trust everything in the Bible. I got questions. Can I tell you, there's nothing wrong with you having questions. God can handle your questions. But sooner or later, you got to move past your questions and step out on this thing called faith. And say, God, I still got questions, but I'm stepping out on faith, and I'm going to choose to believe that you are who you say you are, and you can do what you say you can do. And if even if all of my questions don't get answered, I'm still going to trust you. Even if all of my T's don't get crossed and my I's don't get dotted, I still trust you. Because if you have a God that you can fully understand, that makes him equal to you. There's some things you just won't understand. You got to trust he is God.
Amen.
I am not. People question the living water. Some people in there in the room tonight, maybe you don't question the water, but there's a lot of people that doubt the water. Amen. Doubt the living water. Amen. Ooh, they think you have lost your mind, that you would come into an arena like this on a Friday night, give up your whole weekend. You're going to give up your weekend and go do a church thing? Oh, you have lost your mind. Come on, you could be partying tonight. Man, you could be Netflix and chilling. Why in the world would you come? Oh, no, they think you have lost your mind and they doubt the water's existence. Think this is absolutely crazy. Think this never existed. But if that's you, I dare you, come taste and see. This water is real. It'll satisfy your soul. Some people, I know they in the room tonight, established, everybody here raised in church. You know all about the water. You know all about the water. You've been to water Sunday school. Been to water services. You know it's primarily a substance composed of two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. You know all about the water. You know all about the water songs. You know all about the water. Oh, but there's a vast difference between knowing about the water and actually receiving the water and having a personal relationship with the water. Come on, this right here, what I just did, this is the greatest day of your life. I remember when it happened for me, when I said, I'm not just doing this because my parents made me be in church because I had to be here, but no, I have gotten a revelation that Jesus is the living water. I have received him. He is in my life. Come on, is there anybody in here that has received the living water? And everywhere you go, people can see that you've got the living water. And you go to school and they day of your life. This is your real birthday right here. You receive living water. Hear me? It doesn't stop here. It doesn't stop here. You got to go deeper. Because I can still die of thirst even though I've received this water. You got some people, I'm talking to some leaders, some youth pastors, they know how to preach the water. Oh, you're real good at preaching the water. I mean, you lead a water group. Oh, you're all good at preaching the water. I mean, there's people here I can have the microphone. They can tell you about the water. They can articulate. They can preach the water. They give it to you in solid gas or liquid form. I'm from Dallas, the buckle of the Bible Belt. You can see churches from Dallas right here tonight in Rochester. I'm telling you, there's people that can preach the water. They can say, hey, Lord, this water will satisfy. This water will touch your soul. If you got some of this water, it'll change your life. Slap your neighbor, say water, water, water. Raise the water. But isn't it funny, hear me, youth pastor, hear me, youth leader, and you can be preaching about the water and you'd be totally dehydrated. Preaching about the water and you're dehydrated, hear me, it's only a matter of time before you fall, because you're not privately drinking what you're publicly preaching. Some people, religious, stuck-up people who look like they've been sucking on lemons and constipated. You know those people. Religious people, they always make this thing. They think it's their job to judge who needs water. Did you see the skirt she had on at the Winterfest? I know she cold. I cannot believe she wore that at the Winterfest. I smelled his breath. I smelled it. You smell what kind of breath? Oh, he needs water. That's your spirit. If you lead a youth group, please just stop. Just stop. We don't need to beat this generation up. We need to build them up. I'm not saying you can't correct them. Just saying. The judge who needs water. Then there's another group, and this is the one I want to hone in on, especially tonight. Y'all good? Is there any like radical young man of God in the place tonight who love Jesus? Radical young man of God. Anybody in here, you're a radical young man of God, you love Jesus, that you just stand up on your feet. Some radical young man of God who loves Jesus with everything in him. Why you right here, man? You right here. Would you come here? Yeah, you come here. How old are you, man? 27. That's awesome, but I want a young person. I was going to say, if you were younger, I was like, what do you eat, bro? We need a check for steroids. I was like, what? No, some young man. My man right here on the front row. Come here, come here, come here. How old are you, man? You're 15. Huh? He is bigger than you. Don't be hating. 15. What's your name, man? Robert. Get out of here, man. Awesome, man. Robert, would you do me a favor? You have some thank you. Just look that way and come to the edge of the stage. Come here. You can go back to your seat. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Just look straight ahead. Robert, you're going to represent something I see happen, especially in this generation. See it happen in conferences all over the world. First of all, for all legal purposes, I want y'all to see Robert chose to come up here. He's not coerced. He chose to come up here. Did y'all see that? He chose to come up here. Robert is going to represent many of you in this room who you love God. You really do. Everything that's within you. Come to a conference service like this, and you're at the front and your hands are lifted. You're at the front and your hands are lifted. Work with me, Rob. I'm just going to get all night. You're at the front and your hands are lifted. And you're so desperate for God to pour out His Spirit all over you. Come to a service like this with your hands lifted and you're at the front. You say things like, God, I want you.
I want you.
I need you.
I need you.
Please pour out your spirit.
Please pour out your spirit.
All over me.
I'm over.
Not I'm over it. Pour it out.
Pour it out.
All over me.
All over me.
Right now. And then nothing happens. Have you ever been there before? Have y'all ever, can we be real in here tonight? Service, and I'm singing every song. I know some of you tonight, you were trying to engage, you were trying to lift up your hands, but the enemy was coming up in your mind with all the stuff you did yesterday and the week before that, and you're trying to engage. You're like, God, I'm singing it, but I just, man, I don't feel anything. So maybe you come another night, another service, your hands are lifted again. Yeah, real high. You cry it out again. You say, God,
God,
I want you.
I want you.
I'm so desperate.
I'm so desperate.
For more of your spirit.
For more of your spirit.
Pour it out.
Pour it out.
On me.
On me.
Right now.
Right now.
And nothing happens. Come on, can I be real in here tonight? Have you ever been there when you're doing all the stuff? You singing the song, you dancing, you doing the hokey pokey, you trying to pay attention, but it's like, God, I don't feel anything. I don't know what's happening. God, where are you? You feel so distant. So you come again to another service or another night, and your hands are lifted. Come on, worship team, work with me, play a little bit. Lift your hands. See, I'm teaching you something right now. You got to get into, we got to get a generation that doesn't stop just because you don't feel it. God is bigger than your feelings.